Hello and welcome to smartiq online classes. This is Venkatesh B. Patil. Today I am going to discuss polity series. In polity series, the very important topic, union and its territories. Union and its territories. So what are the agenda for today's discussion? The constitution positions of the union and its territories. Second one is related articles, means article related to the union and its territories. Next is parliament's power regarding the union and its territories, and evolution of states and related committees for the reorganization of the states or new states. And next one is new state and UTs, union territories, created after the 1956. Okay, these are the topics. These are the topics or concepts are very discussed in today's session. So, what are the union and its territories? What are the union and its territories? Okay. So, these are mentioned in the constitution or not? Okay. Yes, it is mentioned in the constitution. Union and its territories are mentioned in the Indian Constitution in part first. First part is related to the name of the union and its territories. That is Article 1 to 4 is also related to the union and its territories. Once again, the union and territories are mentioned in the part first of the Indian Constitution in the articles of 1 to 4. So look at the first Article 1. What it talks about Article 1? Okay. Name and territory of the union. So Article 1 talks about the name and territory of the union. What is meant? Name and the territory of the union. Here in this article, Article 1 talks about the name of the country as well as the type of the polity of the territory of the union. For example, in India, that is in Article 1, first point it says that in India, that is Bharata, shall be union of states. India, that is Bharata, shall be union of states. What is mean of this sentence? So in 1947, so India getting independence, that is formation of the Constituent Assembly. Okay, in Constituent Assembly there are different opinions related to the name of the country. That is, somebody suggested name is India, that is modern name India, modern state, that is India. Somebody suggested the traditional name called Bharat. So that is the reason the Constituent Assembly adopted both mixed the both Indian modern state as well as the modern name as well as the traditional name. That is the reason India, that is Bharat, shall be union of states. This is a very important. Before going to the concept of union of states, you have to understand what is meant by union and federation. Okay, or federal states. What is the difference between union and federal? In union government, in union of states, there is a single government. Single government, or here there is a dual government. Dual government. In union government or union states, there is a single citizenship is there. Single citizenship. But here, double citizenship is there. Okay, for example, India is a single citizenship. But take as America is a, there is a number of America is a, USA is a, it is a United States of Federal Federation of the 50 countries. 50 countries have different citizenship identities there. But in India, all over India, there is only single citizenship except Jammu and Kashmir. Except Jammu and Kashmir, there is a separate citizenship identity is there. Okay, that is related to the union of states. The states and the territories of shall be specified in the first schedule. Means the first schedule is talks about the Indian Constitution. In the first schedule talks about the name of the states and its union territories. The territory of India can be classified into three categories. In Article 1, it talks about there are three kinds of territories in their Indian Union or Indian states. That is the territories of the states. ರಾಜ್ಯ ರಾಜ್ಯಗಳು ಅನ್ಬೋದು, ಓಕೆ, ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳು ಅಥವಾ ರಾಜ್ಯಗಳು, ಓಕೆ, ದ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಕೇಂದ್ರಾಡಳಿತ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳು, ಕೇಂದ್ರಾಡಳಿತ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳು. ಸೊ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಎಟ್ ಎನಿ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ಓಕೆ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಭಾರತ ಸರ್ಕಾರವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಬೇರೆ ದೇಶದ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳನ್ನು ವಶಪಡಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವುದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಈ ಮೂರು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣುತ್ತದೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ದ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರೀಸ್, ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್, ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಎಟ್ ಎನಿ ಟೈಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ತ್ರೀ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 1 ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2 ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್? ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2 ಈಸ್ ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2 ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಇಯರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂ ದ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಇನ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಬಿಫೋರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ದ ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೇ ಬೈ ಲಾ ಅಡ್ಮಿಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಇನ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಸಚ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಎಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಿಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸಮ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆರ್ ಫಿಟ್ ಟು ದಿ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದ ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಆರ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಟ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಟ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಟೂ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವೆಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಪವರ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪವರ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಟೆಡ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್, ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇನ್ 1664 ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಪಾಂಡಿಚೇರಿ, ಸೊ ಟುಡೇ ಇಸ್ ಪುಡುಚೇರಿ, ಕರೈಕಲ್, ಮಾಯೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯಾನಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ದ ಪೋರ್ಚುಗೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್, ಸಾರಿ ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್. ದೀಸ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಪೋರ್ಚುಗೀಸ್ ಸೆಟಲ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಗೋವಾ, ಡಾಮನ್, ಡಿಯು ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಮನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2 ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಂ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2 ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಂ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಂ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 35 ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಡೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ 35 ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಂ ಇನ್ ದ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂಡರ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 2A. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 3 ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್? ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 3 ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ 3 ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪವರ್ ಟು ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪವರ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ದ ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಬೈ ಲಾ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಬೈ ಸಪರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆರಿಟರಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಯುನೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಯುನೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಟೆರಿಟರೀಸ್ ಟು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಟೇಕ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ತೆಲಂಗಾಣ. ತೆಲಂಗಾಣ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ವಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಎಪಿ. ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ತೆಲಂಗಾಣ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಆಂಧ್ರ ಪ್ರದೇಶ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ದೇರ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ವಿಲೇಜಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್. ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅಲಹಾಬಾದ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಅಲಹಾಬಾದ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಯಾಗ್ರಾಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರೀನೇಮ್ ಇದೆ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, ಮೈಸೂರು ಆಸ್ ಎ ದ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಇನ್ 1970. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್, ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ಏರಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಓಕೆ, Okay, for example here, Gujarat is there, just increasing the area. That is, for example, it's not there, but I will just rough example. They increase the area of the any state, diminish the area of any state. For example, reduce the state like that, Gujarat like that, this state. Alter the boundaries of any state and alter the name of any state. So these are the provisions are to formation form under the parliament format of India. Okay. So next, what is the process for renaming or bordering of the or alteration of the or new formation of the new state? Okay. So these above changes can be introduced in the parliament only with the prior recommendation of the president. Okay, this is the process of formation, alteration, rename of the states through the, this is the process. The parliament has to take the prior recommendation of the president. Before committing the, recommending the bill, the president has to prepare the name to, same to the state legislature. Okay, for example, take for example, here, President Ramnath Kovind is there. Okay, this is the president. So this is the parliament. Here take Karnataka state is there. So parliament, for example, here Mysore is there. The for example here the parliament has changed the name of the state of the Karnataka. Okay, so Karnataka as a so Mysore as a Karnataka. The first you have to take the permission of the president, prior recommendation of the president. The president also to take the advice. What the president has referred to the state legislature concerned expressing its views within the specified term. There is a specified term is there, but here the state's recommendation are not binding by the parliament or president. Okay, the state's recommendation or views are not binding by the president or parliament. The state legislature views not binding. Okay, Article 2 and 3 are not need for the amendment of the constitution under Article 368. So these Article 2 and Article 3 is only not need for the amendment of the Constitution or Article 360 is only for the just the simple majority or simple process simple legislative process. It is only through the simple majority and ordinary legislature process that these process used for the alteration, rename or alteration of the boundaries for the states to the of the parliament. Okay. So here, what is Article 4 which talks about? Article 4 is talks about laws made under Article 2 and 3 to provide for the amendment of the first and fourth schedule and supplemental, incidental and consequential matters. Okay, once again, Article 4 is talks about laws made under Articles 2 and 3 and 2 to provide for the amendment of the first and fourth schedule. Okay, first and fourth schedule. First schedule is talks about the name of the name of the union and its territories. Here the Rajya Sabha allocation of the seats, Article 4, sorry, Schedule 4 it talks about the allocation of seats to the Rajya Sabha. Okay, Schedule 1 is talks about the name of the union and its territories, and Schedule 4 is talks about the allocation of seats to the Rajya Sabha. Andre Rajya Sabha ge ondu enantare seat galanna allocate madavuntadanna 4th 4th anusuchiyalli kanutuntadu. Ondanenu suchi antandre kendra mattu sorry kendra mattu adra pradeshagala ondu hesarana suchisalagiruntadu. Idu Schedule 1 of the Indian Constitution. Look at the here, any law referred to the Article 2 or Article 3 shall contain such provisions for the amendment of the first schedule and fourth schedule of the constitution as may be necessary to give effect to the provisions of the law and may also contain such supplemental, incidental and consequential. Okay, once again, such supplemental, incidental and consequential provisions including the provisions to representation in parliament and legislature or legislatures of the states or states affected by such law as a parliament deemed to necessary. Okay, the parliament may deem necessary. And class 2 talks about no such law as aforesaid shall be deemed to be in the amendment of the this constitution under the Article 368. Okay, so Article 2 and 3 not necessary for the amendment of the Indian Constitution. It is made through the simple majority or ordinary legislative process. Some of the important points to be noted in the Union and Territories topic. So Article 2, so article under the which, article under the, article 2, under which the Sikkim state, Sikkim made a part of the union under article 2A. So article 3A talks about Telangana has made a part of the union, article 3, very important. So article 3 is made a, means there is a separation of states. Okay, so article 3 talks about the Telangana was made part of the Indian Union, separate from the Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is separate from Andhra Pradesh, that is Telangana is separate from the Andhra Pradesh. So article 3, that is a separation of state. So article 3 is original was amended by the constitution, that is 5th Amendment Act of 1955 on 24th December 1955. Okay. So nowhere under the part 1 it is mentioned that India has a federal state. Very, very important. So already discussing what is difference between the union and federal state. Federal state is nothing but there are dual government is there. One is central government, another is state government. And that is a your major function is the function of the federal state is there is a division of powers between the center and the state. Here both are equal in equal powers in the nature, but union state, that is a center is majority of the powers in the hands of the central government rather than the state government or provincial governments. So the word federation is nowhere mentioned in the Indian constitution. Okay, it rather uses the phrase of union of states. Very important. In the Indian constitution, the only word uses of the union of states rather than the federation of states. Why only India mentioned union of states rather than the federation of states? For example, take here, there is a union of states, here federation of states. So union of state is good example is Indian Union. Okay, India. The federation of state is example is America. So what is the difference between the union of states like India, federation of state like USA? In Indian states, in Indian means the state of states are there in the India. There is no agreement between the states and center. These states are made by the central government or union government. That's the reason. Very one important statement is there. That is a indestructible union, but destructible states. That is related to the union of states. What is the context of in India? That is, here the union cannot be destroyed, but the state can be destroyed. For example, okay, for example, the Indian government means the Indian government can destroy the state of Karnataka, but the Karnataka state cannot destroy the central government. That is the meaning of the indestructible union but destructible states. In the American context, that is a federation of states. In federation of state, it talks about that is indestructible union and indestructible states also. Okay, the federation of state like in the USA, that's the main concept is indestructible union and indestructible the states. So what is the meaning of this one? For example, take America plus 50 states are there. Here there is an agreement between the states and America. Okay, in American states can be withdrawn from the any time. That's the reason here indestructible union and indestructible states, not indestructible, here destructible union and destructible states is there. Okay, that is the federation of states of the in America. America is the oldest federation of states in the world. Okay, that's very important. America is the oldest federation of states in the world. Okay, here the territorial waters and exclusive economic zones. Okay, EEZ, exclusive economic zones shall also become a part of the states or union territories in the absence of any listing of them separately in Schedule 1 and 4 of the Indian Constitution. Schedule 1 talks about the names of the union and its territories, and Schedule 4 talks about the allocation of seats to the Rajya Sabha. So sixth point is that the territorial waters and exclusive economic zone shall be become a part of the states or union territories in the absence of the listing them separately in the schedule 1 and 4 of the constitution. Okay. Next is Indian territory can be ceded to a foreign state only by the amending of the constitution under article 360. Is very very important for PT. Okay. So what is this? Indian territory can be ceded to a foreign state only by amending the constitution under article 368 of the Indian constitution. For example, 9th constitutional amendment act of 1960 transfer the said territory of the Pakistan. Okay, for example, take here Jammu and Kashmir is there, the union of India, the union government, here Pakistan is union government, the Jammu Kashmir place territory is given to the Pakistan. That time the amendment of the constitution need be necessary is there. That is the in previous year, that is 9th constitutional amendment act of 1960 to transfer the said territory of the Pakistan through the amendment under the article 368 of the Indian constitution. In Supreme Court in 1969 verdict ruled that the settlement of a boundary dispute between the India and other country does not require a constitutional amendment. It can be done by executive action as it does not involve the secession of Indian territory to a foreign country. Okay, what is the meaning of this? For example, here India is there. Okay, here China is there. Okay, what is there? So in Supreme Court of India 1960 ruled that settlement of boundary between, okay, here boundary is there, that is called what boundary? Macmillan line. Okay, Macmillan line between the border between the India and China. Segment of boundary between the dispute between the India and China. Other countries does not require that. There is not constitutional amendment for the, that is alteration of the boundaries or dispute between the boundary between the two countries. But you have to provide in the, it was given to the states to the other countries. That is amendment of the constitution is necessary. Okay. So evolution of the states and union territories. Okay, how evolution of the states and union territories? So before, okay, British came to India, British East India Company. So India is not a the complete, okay, state is there. Okay, for example, here Jammu and Kashmir kingdom is there, here Sikkim is there, here Gujarat is, Rajasthan is, Punjab there, Mysore is there. So okay, so here Tamil Nadu and Kerala is there. Different, there is a province, princely states are there. After the India getting that one, there is 552 princely states are there in India. Princely states are in India. After the Indian Independence Act, so providing the princely states to join India, to join Pakistan, remain independent. Okay. After the India getting independence, there are 552 princely states are there. There is a total one of the union state is there. That time there is a no complete India is there. There is a fragmented princely states are there. That is total is 552 was there. The Indian Independence Act of 1947 providing for the princely state, that is the princely states can join the India or join the Pakistan nor you become independent. So after getting India independence in 1947, there are 549 princely states are joined to the Indian Union except Hyderabad, Jammu and Kashmir and Junagadh. So these three states are come under the Union of India. That is, in Hyderabad, the princely state is ruled by the Nizam. The Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel take action, that is the first Home Minister of India, is take action on Operation Follow. Okay, it's Operation Follow is a police action in September 17, 1948. Hyderabad, the princely state of Hyderabad becoming the Indian Union, and Jammu and Kashmir also, before it is a princely state, is there, is ruled by the Hindu king Maharaj Hari Singh. He is also that is instrument of acquisition agreement. Instrument of accession agreement through India, Jammu Kashmir is also part of the India. After end, that is in Junagadh, so it is in Gujarat. The principal state of Junagadh also come through the India through this referendum. ಜನಮತಗಳನ್ನ ಮೂಲಕ ಜುನಾಗಢ ಕೂಡ ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇರ್ಪಡೆಗೊಳ್ಳಿತು. ಸೊ ಇದು ಒಂದು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆಗುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಸಂದರ್ಭ. ಸೊ ಕಮಿಟೀಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ರೀಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ ಥ್ರೀ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಅಡೋಕ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅಡೋಕ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟೆಂಪರರಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. South India for demanding the different reasons or different statehood for the reorganization of the states on the linguistic basis. Most of the South Indian states are so demanded for the separate state for the linguistic on the linguistic basis. That's the reason the government of India appointed a SK Dhar committee. It's very very important for PT both mains examination. So that's the reason the government of India appointed a committee called SK Dhar committee in the 1948. It is also called the Linguistic Provinces Commission. Okay, it is also called the Linguistic Provinces Commission in 1948. It is through the headed by the SK Dhar to find the possibilities to recognize states on the linguistic basis. Okay, it is to study and to possibilities to recognize the states on linguistic basis. After giving the report recommendation of the SK Dhar committee is to recommend the on the basis of the administration. Okay, the creation of the new state on the basis of the administration, not a linguistic basis. Okay, and the linguistic basis recommended. So what is possibilities cancelled by the rejected by the SK Dhar committee. SK Dhar committee in the 1948. So after that, the government the agitation week more in the Indian government of in India. That's the reason again another committee is appointed by the government of India, that is called JVP committee in 1949. So what is JVP committee? Here Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabhbhai Patel, Pattabhi Sitaramai, the three members committee is appointed by the government of India because of failure of the SK Dhar committee to organization of the states on the basis of linguistic basis. That is a three member committee, Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabhbhai Patel, Pattabhi Sitaramai. It is to find the possibilities to recognize the states on linguistic basis. Again, the same objective to study the states reorganization of the states on the basis of linguistic basis. But this committee is also rejected the basis of linguistic basis. Okay, the organization of the states on the linguistic basis recommend is rejected by the JVP committee. So after that, in all India, especially in South India, there is a lot of hesitation happens. That's the reason government of India in October 1953 forced to create the first linguistic state of Andhra Pradesh. Once again, there is a lot of vegetation in South India. That's the reason the government of India in October 1953 forced to create. It's not in independently, it's not interestingly, it's forced to create the first linguistic state of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, the first linguistic state is Andhra Pradesh by separating the Telugu speaking people. Okay, it is a basis. This is a basis of the linguistic basis. Okay, linguistic basis. Andhra Bhasha Vara Vadar Mile, Andhra Pradesh Avanu, Madhara Bhasha Vara Pranthi Mile, Raja Vana Agi, Madhavadu, Andhra Pradesh, other especially Telugu Matra Vanta Janangu, Pradesh Avanu, Andhra Pradesh Vili, says Vantadu. So, it is from the Madras state. Andhra Madras state in the Madras state in the Telugu Matra Vanta Bhasha Karana, Vantakada Vantu, Andhra Pradesh Vanta, Vasa Raja Vana, Nirmanamalaitu. ಸೊ ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ಥರ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಂತಂದರೆ ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ 56 ಡೇ ಅಂಗರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ 56 ದಿನಗಳ ಒಂದು ಸತತವಾದಂಥ ಏನಂತಾರೆ ಹಸಿವಿನಿಂದ ಹೋರಾಟ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಉಪವಾಸ ಸತ್ಯಾಗ್ರಹ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇದರಿಂದ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ ದ ಡೆತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೊಟ್ಟಿ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮಲು, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಪೊಟ್ಟಿ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮಲವರು 56 ದಿನಗಳ ಉಪವಾಸ ಸತ್ಯಾಗ್ರಹ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವರು ಪ್ರಾಣವನ್ನು ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಎಜಿಟೇಷನ್ ವೈರಸ್ಗಳಾಗ್ತವೆ. ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನಂದರೆ ಭಾರತ ಸರ್ಕಾರವು ಒಂದು ಅಂದರೆ ಆಂಧ್ರ ಪ್ರದೇಶನ ಅಂತ ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ತೆಲುಗು ಮಾತನಾಡುವಂಥ ಭಾಷಿಕರ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ರಾಜ್ಯವನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಫಜಲ್ ಅಲಿ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ರೀಆರ್ಗನೈಜೇಷನ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ರೀಆರ್ಗನೈಜೇಷನ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ reorganization committee. So members are Fazal Ali is the chairman of this committee, and H.N. Kunju and K.M. Panikar, very important. H.N. Kunju and K.M. Panikar also member of this committee. This is the three members body headed by the Fazal Ali, and other two members are H.N. Kunju and K.M. Panikar, accepted, recognize the states on linguistic basis, very very important. S.K. Dhar committee and JVP committee to rejected the recognition of the states on the basis of linguistic basis, but Fazal Ali committee is accepted the recognition of the states on the basis of linguistic basis, but not as a sole factor. Andre, but not as a sole factor. Andre, one andre, bahasa bahasa orang macam mana marbodo, itu one day one factor allah, itu one day one bishaya allah thay itu. Also suggested the abolition of fourth part classification of states, that is part A, part B, and part C, and part D. Okay, so before, after the Indian Independence Act of 1947, the Union of India is divided into Part A, Part B, Part C, and Part D. Okay, so these are the Union and Territories are divided into four different manner. That is the JVP committee abolition of these categorization, as well as the creation of the 16 new states and three centrally administered union territories. Okay, and it is a suggestion or recommended to the creation of the 16 states and three centrally administered territories, and also suggested, these are the important suggestions given by the recommendations of the Fazal committee. Suggestions are recommendation is given by the Fazal Ali committee. What are the recommendation? Linguistic and cultural homogeneity. Okay, linguistic and on the basis of linguistic and cultural homogeneity, states can recognize on the basis of linguistic and cultural homogeneity, and preservation and strengthening of the unity and security of the nation. Okay, the preservation and strengthening of the unity and security of the nation, and financial, economic, and administrative consideration also one of the important aspect to recognize the new states. And also the planning and promotion of the welfare of the people in each state, as well as of the nation as a whole. Okay, these are the important recommendation given by the Fazal Ali committee for the recognition of the new states on the basis of linguistic basis. Some of the new states and UTs created after the 1956, that is reorganization of the states of Act of 1956. After that, there are some states are formation and duties are created. The first is Andhra Pradesh, created by the State of Andhra Pradesh Act of 1953. Okay, by the carving over some areas from the state of Chennai. Okay, that is Madras. Madras state. Okay, present that is Chennai. Gujarat and Maharashtra, as the state of Mumbai was divided into. Okay, state Mumbai state. Into the two states, that is Maharashtra, that is Marathi speaking people. Okay, Marathi speaking people's region are separated by the Madras state, as well as Madras and Gujarat. That is Mumbai Reorganization Act of 1960. Next is Kerala, the created by the States Reorganization Act of 1956. It comprises the Travancore and Cochin areas. Before that is a Travancore state, is there like Junagadh, Jammu and Kashmir, Hyderabad. That is Travancore state, that is separate to the States Reorganization Act of 1956, made a Kerala as the new state. And Karnataka, the created from the princely state of Mysore. Okay, very important. By the State Organization Act of 1956, it renamed as Karnataka in the 1973 November 1. So next is Nagaland. It was carved out from the state of Assam. Okay, carved out of the state of Assam by the State of Nagaland Act of 1952. Okay, State of Nagaland Act of 1952. It's separated from the state of Assam, that is the state called Nagaland. Next is Haryana. It was carved out from the state of Punjab by the Punjab Representation Reorganization Act of the 1966. Okay, it is from the Haryana. Next is Himachal Pradesh. Here one Haryana and Punjab. There before that, there's Haryana is separate state and Punjab is separate state. Himachal Pradesh, the Union Territory of the Himachal Pradesh. Before present day Himachal Pradesh, the state is there. Before that, it is a Union Territories. Was elevated to the status of state by the State of Himachal Pradesh Act of 1970, made through the, it is a, one of the state of the Union India. And next is Meghalaya, the first carved out as a sub-state within the state of Assam by 23 Constitutional Amendment Act of the 1969. Later in 1971, reissued the status of full-fledged state in the 1971. In the 1971, Meghalaya becomes a full-fledged state by the Northeastern Areas Reorganization Act of the 1971. So next is Manipur and Tripura. Both states were elevated from the states of Union Territories by the Northeastern Reorganization Act of 1971. After that, those becomes a full-fledged state. Full-fledged state. Next is Sikkim. Sikkim was the first given status of associated state, okay, under the 35th Constitutional Amendment Act of the 1974, and also Article 2A is related to the state of Sikkim. Okay, it is a, before that it is a associated state. Okay, it is ruled by the Chogyal Kingdom. Chogyal Kingdom. So very important, Chogyal Kingdom. We were studying the history. It becomes a full state in the 1975 by the 36th Constitutional Amendment Act of the 1975. 36th Constitutional Amendment Act of 1975 deleted the 35th Constitutional Amendment Act as well as 2A and 10th Schedule. Okay, 36th Constitutional Amendment Act of 1975 deleted the 2A as well as 10th Schedule of the Indian Constitution. The next is Mizoram. It was elevated to the status of full state by the State of Mizoram Act of 1986. Okay, Mizoram is a full state in the Mizoram State of the Mizoram Act of 1986. And next is Arunachal Pradesh. It reached the status of full state by the State of Arunachal Pradesh Act of 1987. Okay, it is also in 1987 it becomes a full fledged state of Arunachal Pradesh in the Union of India. And next is Goa. Goa separated from the Union Territories. Before it is a Union Territories of Goa, Diu and Daman was made a full-fledged state of the Goa. Okay, Diu and Daman also Union Territories there. Goa becomes a full-fledged state. Diu and Daman Reorganization Act of 1987, but Diu and Daman renamed as a Union Territories. Okay, Goa is a full-fledged state. Diu and Daman, or Daman and Diu, is a present is Union Territory status. Next is Chhattisgarh, formed the Constitutional Amendment Act of 2000 by the dividing Madhya Pradesh on the November 1, 2001, the Chhattisgarh was separated from the Madhya Pradesh in the Act of Constitutional Amendment Act of the in 2000. Next is Uttarakhand, formed by the Constitutional Amendment Act of 2000, both are in the same year, Chhattisgarh and Uttarakhand, 2000 by providing the Uttar Pradesh on the November 9, 2000, okay, it is from the Uttar Pradesh, it is from the Madhya Pradesh. Next is Jharkhand, formed by the Constitutional Amendment Act of 2000 by the dividing Bihar, it is from the Bihar on the November 15, 2000, the same year as, okay, three states, Chhattisgarh, Uttarakhand and Jharkhand are separated from the those states, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh in the year, same year, that is in 2000. So changes of the names of the some states. So United Provinces, okay, before the name of the Uttar Pradesh, okay, renamed as a Uttar Pradesh in the 1950. United Provinces is a state. It is renamed as a Uttar Pradesh in the 1950. Next is Madras was renamed as a Tamil Nadu in the 1969. Mysore as a renamed as a Karnataka state in the 1973 November 1. Okay, November 1 is celebrated as a Karnataka days. Okay, Lakhadweep Minikoi, Amendu, Icelands. Okay, there are three important Icelands are there in Arabian Ocean. So Arabian Sea, that is a Lakhadweep, Minikoi, Amendu Icelands, renamed as a, that is a single name called Lakshadweep in the 1973. In 1992, UT of Delhi, okay, Union Territories of Delhi has renamed as a, renamed as a National Capital Territory under the 69th Constitutional Amendment of the 1992. Very important is. So it's called NCD. 1992, the UT, Union Territory of Delhi, is renamed as a National Capital Territory under the 69th Constitutional Amendment Act of 1991. In 2006, Uttarakhand has renamed as a Uttarakhand. Okay, in the 2006, Uttarakhand has renamed as a Uttarakhand. Again in 2006, the Pondicherry has renamed as a Puducherry. Okay, Puducherry is not only single territory, it is there are important territories are there. That is a Puducherry, Yanam, Karaikal, Mai. Okay, the four territories are combined together, it is called, it is a Union Territories of the Puducherry. The before name is called Pondicherry. In 2006, Pondicherry has renamed as Puducherry. In 2011, Orissa has renamed as Odisha. Okay, in 2011, Orissa has renamed as Odisha. Okay, so this is about the topic of Union Territories. In this topic, I'll discuss what is the constitutional position of the names of the Union Territories, what is the powers of Parliament regarding the alteration, rename or establishment or admission of the new state regarding the Union Territories and states, and also I'll discuss about the important commissions and commissions are there, right? Changes of their names and their statehood activities. Okay, so these are issues are discussing today very detailed manner. So thank you once again being with us. Thank you once again. See you the next session. Bye bye. Thank you.